I'm the executive director at Breaking Down Barriers Independent Living Resource Center. We are located in Collingwood, but through our various programs, we do cater to everybody throughout the Georgian Triangle, as well as Simcoe, Grey and Bruce counties. Breaking Down Barriers provides supports, services, and programs to enhance the opportunity for people with diverse disabilities, or as we like to say, of all abilities, to live independently in the communities of South Georgian Bay, Simcoe, Grey, and Bruce counties. And what we as an organization envision is a community that can access resources that enable and support people with diverse disabilities and all abilities to basically be able to live their lives with their support network and participate without barriers in all aspects of our society. Now, we're in unprecedented times these days with everything that's going on with COVID-19. But we did want to assure everybody who lives in all the communities that we serve that as an essential service, we are still providing our services, our programs, but we've modified how we're doing that. So one of the changes that we've had to do, and that was at an earlier start on March 13th, is we had to suspend our programs that we would normally have on site or within the community. And that was basically for everybody's safety and protection, as we do work with the population in the vulnerable sector. So it was to ensure the health and safety, which is a top priority for us, for everybody that we serve, as well as for our staff, our volunteers. So we're calling up our folks that are members, and we have those phone numbers to reach out, making sure that they're okay at home. We're reaching out via email for those that use email. And we're also reaching out on social media a lot more. So, but we also haven't forgotten that there are a few people that might not have phones and also might not be using email. So what we have also done is one of our wonderful staff members has created these beautiful newsletters that come out. One is called the Consumer Report, and we're mailing those out just to ensure that no one is forgotten about during this time, as we know that it's created some additional stress and anxiety for everyone. So we know that everybody's day-to-day routine at this time has been disrupted because we're not using the normal transit we would be using. We're not going out to the public places that we might pick up a coffee and sit down and enjoy. So we know that for all of our members, for our consumers, the disruption within their regular schedules, those are some changes. And what we have been letting everybody know, as well as through the newsletters and in our communications to them, talking about coping skills. And one of the things we've suggested is try to maintain some form of a regular routine. Even though you might not be going out to that coffee shop that you normally go to, have the cup of coffee at home. And, you know, if we're not having that cup of tea or cup of coffee that we normally would in that social gathering, what we're suggesting is you can still do that by phone. You can have your cup of coffee and tea with your friend, but we're doing it over the phone. And for those that are familiar with using video conferencing, whether it be through social media platforms that have that ability of doing that, whether it's WhatsApp, whether it's on Facebook, or for those that are using Zoom in different capacities, there are great ways to have that face-to-face interaction. Just like today, we're having this interview via Skype. As we sort of continue, what we also wanted to do is engage everybody with some of our programs online. And one of the first initiatives we took as an organization and in our effort to hashtag plank the curve was we invited one of our, like a dear volunteer who's every year part of the Elvis Festival in Collingwood, would come out and would do a concert for our members. So we reached out to him and his family, and they were really nice, and they did a concert for us on Facebook. So I think the most important thing that we would want to say right now to the community, to our members, to our consumers, is you're not alone. We are thinking of you. We are here to support you, as we always have. in a different capacity, but we're still here and we are still going to make sure that all the regular services that you normally would be obtaining that assistance, we're still going to be providing that. We're still going to be doing that. It may be a little bit different because we're not seeing you really face to face, but we'll be working on making sure that at least we can do it screen to screen and, you know, calling to hear everybody's voice. And you know what, hang in there, because when this is over, we're going to be appreciating things a lot more.